want to talk about vision, lifting up our eyes. I want us to think about seeing others, seeing positive, seeing a new perspective, seeing God as our source, seeing bigger, see abundance, see transformation, and see unashamed. In Proverbs 29, verse 18, it says, where there is no vision, the people perish. And when we have no vision, that is what causes us to perish. Of all the things that we might think that are causing us to perish, we may think that a disease or a troubling circumstance or a difficulty in our lives is causing us to perish. It's actually not that. It's a vision that's not there that causes us to perish. In the middle of disasters, if you can get a vision about the future, that will cause you to come alive and overcome the difficulty you're facing. A vision is like oxygen to your spirit. If you don't breathe oxygen into your lungs, you will perish, you will die. If you don't breathe vision into your spirit, you will die on the inside. In Romans 15, verse 13, the Bible tells us that God is the God of hope. He's the God of hope. So every time things are feeling hopeless, that's not God. God is the God of hope. The devil is the demon of hopelessness and despair. But God, when he comes into your life, he gives you hope. And it says in that scripture that now may the God of hope fill you with all joy. To be filled with all joy is to not have any sadness or depression or grief inside of us, but we are joyful. Fill you with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit and God himself, when they come into your life, bring joy and hope and peace. Now, I've met some believers, some Christians, who think that being miserable is more Christian than being happy. They think that going through life hard and tough and in serious, lemon-faced, sour-spirited, angry attitude is somehow more Christian than being a joyful, successful, prosperous person in life. Unbelievable that we could think that God is a miserable person. He's not. He's God. And in spite of all the difficulties that go on planet Earth, God is joyful. And when you connect with him, you connect with joy. You connect with peace. You connect with hope. You connect with a vision for your future. Throughout the Bible, you will find God healing people of blindness. Jesus healed men. 7 people of blindness, and they were all men. People who needed to see again. Joseph mentioned earlier how Samson had his eyes gouged out. Well, God can put eyes back in sockets. And Jesus did that with the blind. There were some who had no eyeballs in their sockets. But when he touched them, they got vision. When Jesus Christ touches you, you get vision for your life. Even if you've been blind, even if you've never had a vision, you suddenly can see. In fact, when you meet Christ for the first time, the eyes of your spirit are opened. Paul prays. He says, I pray that the eyes of your heart be opened. And in fact, we can find that sin closes those eyes and we can't see anymore. But inside of us, we have a duplicate set of eyes. And with those eyes, we can see vision. Where we point that vision is very important.